Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at Rabbit, the very first Visual Basic Script, or VBS virus, to ever exist. This was written in the late 90s, and although it is exceedingly simple as far as VBS viruses go, it paved the way for many more to come, including the infamous Love Letter Worm that took down computer networks all over the world in the year 2000. We can go ahead and open this up and check out what it does. It's only 11 lines of code, and two of those are comments. Basically, all it does is scan through the current directory and overwrite every VBS file with a copy of itself. And if the day is the 15th of the month, then it opens up the Codebreakers website. And Codebreakers was a virus writing group in the late 90s, early 2000s, and this particular sample was coded by Lord Natas. So you can thank him for helping to pave the way for Visual Basic Script malware. And one last thing to check. On our desktop, we have a test.vbs. All it is a message box. You run it, it says hello, and that's it. So let's get right to the virus. Go ahead and run it. And nothing apparently happens. But if we look at our previous test.vbs, it is no longer a simple message box. It has been overwritten with the contents of the virus. So this goes both ways. It doesn't care which one we're running. Each one is overwriting the other. Pops up a command box. Sometimes you can see it. There was a second variant of this virus. And the only thing it changed was it removed that command prompt box from popping up when it executed, and it also auto-ran the Codebreakers website. So let's see that payload real quick in action. Change to the 15th, run any of these, get the message box, VBS V1.0, click OK, and we get a shortcut to the Codebreakers website, codebreakers.org. Unfortunately, it no longer exists. We get a parked domain page if it ever loads here on our excellent IE5, I believe. Here we go, it loaded. Okay, that's fine. I'm completely fine with web pages not showing okay. I can't imagine why that might happen. But yes, we are on Internet Explorer 5, and the colors are really washed out for some reason. My virtual machine is going nuts. But this domain is parked. And you can really see how something as simple as this can help pave the way for future viruses and worms and all that stuff, because if we edit this, it's very easy to read and just sort of see what's going on. And we can change this. Instead of star.vbs, how about star.star? That'll infect every file in the directory. And yes, I want to save these changes. And let's add a new file here. New bitmap image. Okay. Cool. No. Cool.bitmap. There we go. And it's cool. I cannot write with the mouse. But there we go. Cool. Pops up. It's good. Now we run this. And our file has been overwritten. We see it jumped positions here. And now Paint cannot read this file, unfortunately. If we change this to something that we can open in Notepad real easily, we can see it has indeed been overwritten. And we can unleash some real havoc here. If we go to our Windows directory, and we just put this right here, and let's run it. Alright, you can see the command prompt going through every file, and scroll down. Nothing opens anymore. No text documents will open because Notepad no longer works. Oh, what's going on here? I don't even know, but it looks like we broke it, so go us. Alright, we're attempting to get on here. Defrag does not work. M386, nope. Explorer still works. All right, we're moving on up in the world. We're doing all right for ourselves. Net.exe, no. Netstack, get out of here. You know, anything we run. Can't open text, can't open bitmaps. They're all invalid. Paint still works. Amazing. I can't believe it. Paint has held on. I am so proud of you. And if we go ahead and restart here, we will see that it won't error out upon restarting because all of our files are still present. However, they've been overwritten. So our computer hangs on this Windows 98 screen because it can't actually load any of the files to boot the operating system. So something like Rabbit could be, and indeed was, incredibly dangerous because although simple and not that destructive overall, it could easily be changed, as we see, to become incredibly destructive. And it sort of, you know, plants that seed in the brains of other authors of the period. See, now there's a new method of writing malware. You can use the Windows script process, and you can just cruise on into anybody's files, overwrite, delete, do whatever you want. Eventually that got evolved into emailing, and we saw stuff like Love Letter and Anna Kournikova, which I haven't taken a look at on this channel, but maybe I should. And that is about it. Thank you for watching. Take care.